Binance is one of the easiest and safest ways to buy cryptocurrencies. So if you're new to crypto and want to get your feet wet by purchasing some Bitcoin or other altcoins, then Binance is a great option for you. I will show you step by step how to buy Bitcoin on Binance in this beginner-friendly tutorial. Then later in the video, I will guide you through the more advanced way of buying your crypto. It is a bit more difficult, but is well worth your time mastering because they have much lower trading fees and will save you a lot of money in the long run. I've also made a free custom crypto trading calculator for you, which will help keep track of your investment and trading profits. And I'll show you how to get access to this later on in the video. So make sure to stick with me to the end. But for now, let's get started. First, click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It'll take you to the correct Binance sign up page to get you started if you don't have an account yet. And from here, you just have to enter in your email, password, then click create account. Pull this slider to the correct position. Now get your verification code from your email. Type that in and you're all set. Your account is ready to go. And now let's go to their homepage by clicking on go to dashboard. Next, we need to secure our account by adding two-factor authentication. And I'm gonna use Google verification instead of the phone verification here. Click on that. And now we just follow the steps provided by Binance. Either download the app from the App Store or Google Play. And now we scan the QR code, click next again. Now click here to get the code. So it will be sent to your email address. Type that code in from your email and then type in your new code from your Google authentication and click submit. And once you have done that, you're ready to go and purchase your Cardano. And there are two ways of doing this, the easier way, which has higher fees, or the harder way, which has less fees. So I'll show you the first way, which is the easier way. And that is using your credit or debit card. And you can do this by going to buy crypto and click on credit/debit card. It will take you to this page where you can choose the currency that you want to sell and the currency that you want to buy. In this example, I'm happy to stick with US dollars and I'm also going to be buying Bitcoin. So also keeping it the same is fine. But if you want to change any of the assets, then all you have to do is click here and choose the one you want. But for this one, USD is fine. So I'll select that. Now let's say I want to buy $100 worth of Bitcoin. I would just type in 100 here. Or if you want to buy a certain amount of Bitcoin and you don't care what the dollar value is, then you would just type in, for example, 0.002 Bitcoin. And that is worth $76.89. And if you're happy with that, then you just click on continue. And now we're presented with a page to add our credit or debit card. But if you have not verified your personal details yet, this page will not come up. You'll have to go and click through to the verification page and verify your account instead. So you can see here, my account is already verified, but if you haven't yet, you'll have to click on verify now. And here's an example where you have to either provide your driver's license or your passport details, and then upload an image of yourself, then take a photo of your face, and that's part of the verification process involved. This is required on all exchanges if you ever want to purchase any of your cryptocurrencies with your fiat money. So now let's say you've done that, and I'm going to click on add new card. Now my card has been successfully added, I'll click on continue. Now this will take me to the final page where you can see the amount of Bitcoin I'm going to receive, what the rate is, and what my fees are. You can see my fees here for this transaction will be around 2%, but it can go up as high as 3.5%. using this method. So even though it is really easy, as you can see here, all you have to do is click on confirm, it is very expensive. So for a $200 or $300 transaction, it's not a big deal because the difference will only be a few dollars. But if you're buying thousands or hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of crypto, then I definitely recommend you use the next option where you'll save a ton of money on fees. You can see here from the fee schedule, it can go as low as 0.075% if you decide to use BNB as the fee payment method. So this is around 4 or 5 times cheaper than the first method. The only negative on this second method is it's gonna take a few days for your payment to arrive to Binance because it's gonna use the bank transfer method. Here's a quick question for you. What percentage of your portfolio do you plan on holding in Bitcoin and why? Let me know in the comments section below.
We'll go back to the buy crypto section and click on bank deposit. And now we just select the currency you want to use. In this case, I'm happy with the US dollars, so I just select that. And you can see the fees is $0. So that's a good start, right? Now we can click on continue. For this part, just put in the amount you want to deposit, 1000 as an example, click on continue, click confirm. and now you're presented with the information that you need to put in when you're transferring through your bank account. So what you need to do is to log into your bank account and make a payment to Binance using this exact information with the reference code added. Make sure you click on this to copy all the lines one by one so you don't make any mistake. This is very important. A quick note here is that your USD will be deposited as BUSD. This is Binance version of the US dollar. So when you're trading, this is the one that you should be selecting. And the other thing is, it'll take 2 to 4 business days for your funds to arrive, which is normal for bank transfer anyway. But just so you're aware, it's not going to be there immediately. And now let's say our funds have arrived into Binance. The next step is to go to trade and click on convert. This will take us to the page where you can swap your assets. So as I said, I've deposited US dollars. So I'm gonna click here and type in BUSD, and there's my $1,000. And I want to convert it to Bitcoin as I'm trying to buy Bitcoin. But if you wanna buy a different currency, also you can click here and choose the one you want. But for this example, let's say $100 worth of Bitcoin, and I just click on preview conversions, and it's gonna show you my rate and the amount that I'll receive. So you can see this is as easy as the first method, except you just have to wait a little while for your bank transfer to come through. Do you like the level of detail I'm providing in my Bitcoin Binance tutorial so far? If yes, make sure to let me know by liking my video, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on more quality content that I'll be releasing every single week relating to crypto. But now, if you're more advanced, or you want to be more strategic and set some buy orders below the current value, or set some take profit amounts, then you'll need to use their advanced method. And that is to go to trade and click on advance. And it will take you to this dashboard here where you can see on the left-hand side is the candlestick chart where it is connected to TradingView, and you can do some technical analysis and draw lines and things like that before you buy to make a better informed decision. And in the middle is your order book. And on the right-hand side is where you can click buy and sell your asset. And there are 3 different types of orders: the limit, market, and stop limit. So in this tutorial, I'm not going to go through the limit and stop limit orders, as they are much more complicated and need its own dedicated video to explain to you. And I've done that video here if you want to check it out and go through it. The next thing we want to do is go to this arrow here and go to fiat. And under fiat, I'm going to choose the BUSD because that's what I deposited. But if you added a different currency like the Australian dollar or the euro, then you would click on these buttons here instead. But I'll click on BUSD, and now I want to scroll down to BTC, right? Because we want to buy Bitcoin. So I'll click there, and that's the trading pair that I want to choose. So now that we've got the right pairing, you can go ahead and go to market and type in, let's say $100 I want to buy worth of Bitcoin, and you simply just click on buy BTC, and this will execute a market order and purchase the closest value on your order book immediately for you. And it will show your BTC balance available will be more than zero. It'll be the $100 that we bought.
And if you want my free custom crypto trading calculator, then just go to this link in the description below to get access to that.
So now that you have successfully bought your Bitcoin on Binance, highly recommend you get a crypto wallet to store all your cryptocurrencies and Bitcoin. This is very important because if your exchange like Binance or Coinbase get hacked, then your funds will not be lost, as you currently control your own keys in your own wallet if you get your own private wallet. If you keep it on the exchange, it can easily be lost if the exchange gets hacked. So at a minimum, I recommend you get a mobile wallet. And a free and good one to use is Trust Wallet. This one's created by Binance themselves, but you can download it to your mobile, and this will have your own private keys given to you, so you own the wallet. So even though this is free, it's not the best option. This is because your wallet is just on your phone and is always online, therefore it's still vulnerable to attacks. But if you've only invested a few $100, this is a good option to go with, as the next option can cost you a lot more to get started. So the best option, and the one I recommend, is to use a hardware wallet, like a Trezor wallet or a Ledger wallet. These hardware wallets are essentially a USB stick which you plug into your computer to access your wallet and make transfers online. But the beauty of this option is, if your USB is not connected to the computer, it is essentially a cold wallet. It's not connected to the internet, and no one can hack you if they don't have your private keys, which you're not sharing anyway. So this is the safest and best option to go, but it's going to cost you about $100 to buy one of these hardware wallets. And if you want more information on choosing the best mobile wallet or hardware wallet, then you can check out this video also, which I've done the deep comparison on the best ones.
So if you're ready to proceed with Binance and want to know more about the next step to take, then go to this video. But if Binance is not the right exchange for you, That's not a problem. This is my alternative recommendation for you. So check them out and I'll see you in the next tutorial.